वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई विल कंटिन्यू विद द रूल्स पार्ट. ओके, सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव कंप्लीटेड रूल 1, सो वी विल गो टू रूल 2 टुडे. सो द पेटेंट्स रूल्स 2003 विल कंटिन्यू हियर, और आई विल कंटिन्यू हियर विथ रूल 2, एंड द टाइटल ऑफ रूल 2 इज डेफिनेशंस. Fine. So the below are the standard meanings. Okay, the terms I have written here, they have the standard meanings here, unless and until the context requires otherwise. Okay, that means we can say in normal conditions or in standard meanings. We can say in normal conditions or these terms are having this standard meanings only if nothing is specified. Okay, that's why I have written here that unless the context requires otherwise. Fine. Okay, so let us start with clause A. The term is Act, the Patents Act 1970. That means if in any case, if anywhere we read a term Act, this means the Patents Act 1970. Fine. Similarly, clause B says appropriate office. This means the appropriate office of the patent office is per rule 4 of this patents rule, patents rules 2003. Fine. Then clause C says article. Any substance or material and any plant, machinery or apparatus, whether affixed to land or not. This is article. Fine. Okay. Next one is clause D. The term is form. A form mentioned in the second schedule. Then clause DA. The term is person other than a natural person. This is a small entity. Fine. Then clause DB. Request for examination. A request for examination including expedited examination under section 11B with respect to rule 24B or rule 24C. Clause E, schedule. This is schedule to these rules. We can say here the term schedule means schedule to these rules. Clause F, section. A section of the Act. That means the Patents Act. Fine. Next one is clause FA, and clause FA is about small entity. Okay, so with the help of the subclauses we have defined here. Fine. So subclause 1 says an enterprise engaged in the production of goods, an enterprise where the investment in plant and machinery does not exceed the limit for a medium enterprise under section 7 subsection 1 clause A of the MSME Development Act 2006. And subclause 2 says an enterprise engaged in rendering or providing of services, an enterprise where the investment in equipment is not more than the limit for medium enterprises under section 7 subsection 1 clause B of the MSME Development Act 2006. Just take or we can say just observe the words written in blue ink. Okay, these are the keywords. Next one is we can say for clause FA there are some explanations. So explanation 1 says enterprise is an industrial undertaking or a business concern or any other establishment engaged in the production of goods pertaining to any industry specified in the first schedule to the Industries Development and Regulation Act 1951 or engaged in providing or rendering of any services in such an industry. Fine. Explanation 2 says in calculating the investment in plant and machinery, the cost of pollution control, R&D, that is research and development, industrial safety devices, etc., as may be specified by notification under the MSME Development Act 2006, shall be excluded. So observe the words in blue ink. Fine. Then explanation 3 says the reference rates of foreign currency of the RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India, shall prevail. Fine. Next one is clause FB, and clause FB defines what is a startup. Okay. It is an entity where subclause 1 says more than 5 years more than 5 years have not lapsed from the date of its incorporation or registration. Subclause 2 says the turnover for any of the financial years out of the aforesaid 5 years did not exceed 25 crore rupees. And subclause 3 says it is working towards innovation, development, deployment or commercialization of new products, processes or services driven by technology or IP. IP is intellectual property. Fine. Observe the words in blue. Provided that any such entity formed by splitting up or reconstruction of a business already in existence shall not be taken as a startup. Provided further that mere act of developing a products or services or processes not having potential for commercialization or B says undifferentiated products or services or processes or C products or services or processes with no or limited incremental value for customers or workflow. And just read all this as a whole, and after that the sentence is would not be covered under this definition. That means these things will not be under the definition of startup. Right. Next one is for clause FB. Explanation 1 is an entity shall cease to be a startup on completion of 5 years from the date of its incorporation or registration, or if its turnover for any earlier year or previous year exceeds 25 crore rupees. Explanation 2 says entity means a private limited company as per the Companies Act 2013 or a registered partnership firm registered under Section 59 of the Partnership Act 1932 or a limited liability partnership under the Limited Liability Partnership Act 2002. And explanation 3 is the term turnover shall have the same meaning as per the Companies Act 2013. Fine. Next one is explanation 4. An entity is considered to be working towards innovation, development, deployment or commercialization of new products, processes or services driven by technology or IP. If it aims to develop and commercialize a new product or service or process or an improved existing product or service or process that will create or add value for customers or workflow. Explanation 5 says the reference rates of foreign currency of the RBI shall prevail. Fine. Friends, just observe the keywords that are written in blue ink. And the last clause is G. Words and expressions used but not defined in these rules shall have the meanings respectively assigned to them in the act. That means the words and expressions which are not defined in these rules, their meanings must be as per the the meanings are respectively assigned to them as in the act. That means in the Patents Act 1970. Okay. So any questions? That means all questions are very much welcome in my comment box. This is the last slide. Thank you all. So please friends, please subscribe my channel. Please share my video among your friends. And all types of queries, compliments and comments are welcome in my comment box. Thank you so much friends for your patience to listening my video and listening to me and watching my video. Thank you so much friends. Stay safe, stay blessed.